So high-tech is services, first building block. Service, delivery, right? So what is the service and how do you deliver it? That's what we're gonna cover today. So I feel you. Like the first time I heard about high ticket services, I was like, how am I gonna charge like thousands and thousands of dollars for adults to teach them something? And like, no way, they're not gonna pay me for that, right? Wrong. I was totally wrong. I couldn't be more wrong, my friend. So let me help you and cut the fluff. I already told you, if you ever had a problem in your life that you couldn't solve and eventually managed to find a solution, and you believe that it is a valuable solution, it changed your life in a way, chances are that you can offer someone a high-ticket service. Maybe you really like to geek out on some stuff. Maybe there is something that you talk a lot about. Like, to me, it was fitness all the time. I was geeking out about fitness. Now it's marketing. Like, you can't, like, even if I sit down and like, Blaze, stop talking about business, I keep talking about business. Because at the end of the day, I just love it. I really enjoy it. It's like a game to me. It's super exciting, super interesting. And chances are you have something similar. To be a bit more specific, anything that falls into the health, about relationships, spirituality, lifestyle design, or any kind of like general personal development could be a high ticket service, could be a potential for you to teach something valuable for others. I pretty much covered everything that's sellable on the market right now, because if I just say health, like just imagine how many things you can do. When I say health, people are like, oh yeah, losing weight. Yes, losing weight is the biggest one, but that's not the only one, and you can always specify, like, who are you helping to lose weight? Is it just like everyone? Or is it just women or male? Or like what age demographic they fall into? Or like what do they do? Are they at the university? Or are they like moms or dads? You know, you see where I'm going with this one? You really can specify and carve out a small piece of the pie for yourself and be the known to expert to help your persona, your avatar with that given problem. Maybe It's not even weight loss, right? Like I did some research and I found all kind of crazy stuff. Like for example, there is this syndrome called IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. And I found the coach is helping people to get that sorted. But it is real. Like if you had a problem and you were playing some sort of sport and there were a specific method of solving that, maybe you can help more people with that one. If you know how to find them online and if they are willing to, if the problem is big enough for them to put some money down on the table for you. Or actually, I give you a better one. There are coaches, love coaches, right? They just laugh. Like that's what they do. They sit down with you and they laugh and you're gonna feel better. Isn't that crazy? Like, I mean, I think it justifies that there are no excuses. Like you can find something, be a well-known expert about that and just help people. But before you sit down and do the research, start researching and start thinking, I think it's very important for me to emphasize that having passion is the most important thing out of all. When I started, I was like, where can I make money? That was really my question. Like, hey, let's find something where I can make money, right? Because I was broke, I needed money. And then later I realized that I should have just focused on like, what am I really passionate about? What is the thing that I can't stop talking about? Because here's the thing, making money is good, but having longevity that's where the real wealth happens. When you know that you really like that thing, you're gonna enjoy your work, you essentially gonna be able to put in more work, and because of that you're just gonna accumulate more wealth, you're gonna make more impact, help more people, create more value in the marketplace. Again, don't forget, value created equals money at the end of the day in longevity by and large. So how do you research? Like, this is really important for you to understand. It's not like just you sit down and you're like, hey, yeah, like I don't know, I like whatever, fishing, so you're gonna teach people to fish. Could be a niche as well if you know how to like package that and you find a real problem for those people and solve that. The way to find that problem is to sit down and do market research, read forums, go to Quora, go to Amazon and just like check relevant products and see what they comment, visit Reddit and do a really deep niche research. So whatever you're excited about, probably that's where your niche is gonna be. And then research that topic. Think about like, what is the problem you can solve for those people? And also research, what are your competitors doing on the marketplace? Whatever you pick, you're gonna probably find players that's already been serving that niche, right? Don't get scared. Don't feel like, oh no, I knew it. Someone is already doing it. Whatever. You can't be that guy because the market is huge, it's massive, right? So when you see someone is serving that market, that's a good sign, my friend, right? Because they are making money on that. So all you need to do is just do the niche research, just go to these sites, like type in the keywords, read. I spend like weeks and weeks and weeks just doing this in order to find something that I can create value with. Once it's done, I promise you're gonna find really valuable things. But don't just read, put down your thoughts. Like, pull up a sheet, pull up an Excel, pull up a paper, whatever it is for you, and jot down things, right? Systematically, write down what they do, who they have, what is the offer, how do they sell people, what is the price point, booking a call with them. Try to act like you want to buy their service. Figure out like what they really do. Ask questions. Do whatever it takes. Sign up to their email newsletter. Whatever it takes, figure out what they do and write it down. Like, just pick the top players, really, just like 3-4 should be enough. Bring some articles, blog posts, Quora, Reddit should do the work. Once that's done, you need to identify what is it that you want to do. What is the problem you want to solve? Like, once you identify that, you can create a persona around it. So you need to sit down and really explain what is your target customer avatar. Like, who are they? What are their age demographic? Where do they live? What do they do for a work? What are the biggest struggles? What are their fears, dreams, desires, pain points? What is it that keeps them awake up at night? Like, those sort of things. Those are very, very important. And then comes the offer creation. Once it's all done, you sit down with all your documents and notes and papers. And that's the best part. That's the most exciting part, because finally you are getting closer. Finally, you can make this thing happen, right? And you start writing down what is the problem you are solving for, the exact avatar, and you put everything together and you create an offer around it, right? You think about what needs to happen, what would be the program, what would be a coaching, consulting. Don't overthink it. Just write it down, like, start selling that thing, and then essentially you're gonna get market feedback, and based on that you can iterate the process. The biggest mistake I made back then is that I spent a lot of time trying to figure out like, well, how is it gonna look like, and then yet I never took action, so like wasted a lot of time instead of like going to the market and testing it out. This being said, you need to do a proper job. What you offer need to be realistic, right? It need to be something realistic, and you really need to put down in detail how you want to deliver the service, what is the price you wanna get for it, and then just start reaching out for people and figure out if they actually want it. Like, go to Facebook groups, start networking with people, and essentially you're gonna figure out what do the people really want. So guys, that's what I got for you today. This is how you figure out what's your service, put a price point on it, start testing, and then make sure that you can deliver what you promise. So thank you for watching the video. If you find some valuable information, then as an act of encouragement, drop me a like, drop me some comment if you have any questions, and maybe subscribe, and see you in the next one.